Brian.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 7 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day in the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Let's make it a great week, folks. Kicking off end of the October, beginning of November. Create new agreements based on love and respect. Take the responsibility to make new agreements with those you love. If an agreement doesn't work, change the agreement and create a new one. And use your imagination to explore all the possibilities. Market-wise, let's take a look at it out here. We have the Dow Industrials up 556, NASDAQ up 162, S&P's up 52. Gold contract up $9.70, trading at 2008 an ounce. We have silver up 59 cents, $23.47 an ounce. Late sweet crude down $3.10. $82.44 a barrel, notes and bonds. A 10-year note down 4 ticks at 106.09. 30-year up 1 at 109.16 in King Dollar. King Dollar trading down 58 ticks at 106.101. Euro is at 106. Yen is trading at 149. British pound is at 121 to 1 U.S. dollar. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Give us a call, folks. Want to know what's going on in your world. In the world of the S&Ps, let's take a look at it. Okay, so I want to thank one of the Tigers for giving me a heads up that we very well could have a bad tick here from this morning. So in the SPY. So if we take a look at the SPY, you know, when I did the update, I says, okay, so it went to a lower low. Now, if we do look at it intraday, what you're going to see is that there's a spike that's right there. The real question is, will they fix it later? We'll see. So you got two different deals going on here, for sure. So let's say that it is a bad tick. That being said, the bottom line is that now you're going up on light volume. Okay, I'll take it that it's a bad tick. You're going up on light volume. That being said, however, what you have done is that you came right back to the strength right where it took off from. So I suspect you're going to get a rally here. The real question is that, you know, is it a B to C of an ABC structure down? You know, we'll find out pretty quick. Not pretty quick, because you're going to get some follow through here. You know, when you get wide price spread, which we have in both indices, and you're already come against the strength, you know, you're going to get some follow through. We go into the Qs. We take a look at the Qs, and you can see this is where, you know, when I did the update, I said we had a divergence. Well, now there's not divergence because there's only 43 million shares in the Qs. Now, the Qs were as strong as that they did not come down into where this whole rally started. So the Qs are still strong. You know, they're going to need more volume. There's no doubt about that. But the Qs look like they're going to jump right back into the higher range again. And the higher range inside the Qs are approximately, we're 349 right now, and it's about 358. You know, you still needed about another 10 points to get up into that level. We go look at the notes and bonds. They want higher price, lower yield. There's no sellers inside the bond market out here today. You're down 3 ticks. You only done 131,000 contracts out here. You know, so the bottom line is that's still saying that it wants higher price. Now, what is intriguing is that there's going to be plenty of bonds that are getting issued. But the fact of the matter is that now this is still one of the biggest issues that the Treasury has ever done. But the fact of the matter is that they've actually collected more from all the U.S. citizens paying their taxes, and they need less money on this borrowing this quarter. So they were expecting to borrow $852 billion, and now it's going to be $776 billion. So the bottom line is that, you know, that the U.S. government is taking in a lot of bread, period, you know, so notes, bonds, dollar. Let's go to the dollar, because the dollar is what's giving this market breathing room right now. You know, last week what we were doing, you were building cars and the dollar. Sideways move. Try to get higher. Couldn't handle it. In fact, gave it up on price. Now you're getting wide price spread, you know, on the way down again. So I suspect what we're going to see here is that The dollar wants to make a run to the 104.699. If you remember that area, folks, that was the area where we broke out of. You know, it took you know, about a week and a half to get into it. To pull back. It's actually one, two, three. It's about 3 weeks that we were laying at that area. Then it took off. So what it tends to happen is that as you come back, that's where we're going to probably lay out for a bit. You'll build more calls. Then you'll get down into this, you know, 99.365 area. We go take a look at, one of these. This gets interesting. If you're in the gold market, in fact, if you get the gold report, you're going to know that this morning, so this is really wild. Franco Nevada, folks, okay, has always been one of the best streamers out there. Big gold company, right? And in the gold report today, I'm putting like, oh, man, you know, there was a couple good buys out there today in the gold market. But my concern was Franco Nevada. Now, this is before the news came out. And what it was Franco Nevada hasn't been moving. And Franco Nevada is one of the best streamers out there, okay? Well, bottom line is that what ended up happening, you know, when the market opened up here, is Franco Nevada is down 11 bucks right now, trading 126. And what it was is that they have a streaming deal with First Quantum out of and Panama. And that could be at risk right now. The bottom line is that First Quantum, there's going to be a, yeah, First Quantum's trading down $8. Look at this. You talk about getting smoked, man. First Quantum is down $8, trading $19. That's just got taken apart. And what that's all about is that they're going to face a referendum. First Quantum shares plunged the most in 20 years after the Panama government said it would hold a referendum on the company's flagship copper mine in an effort to quell mass civil unrest. Shares of the Canadian mine, you know. So the bottom line is that you can see what's happening, okay? One of their mine, which is one of the newest copper mines, has become a political flashpoint in the nation. A contract awarding a 20-year extension to First Quantum's mining license was signed into law by Panamanian president earlier in October, sparking fury in the country and leading protesters to block highways and clash with police. Seeking to appease opponents, said on Sunday that the national vote will be held on December 17th in order to revoke the license. You know, there's some political risk in a monster way. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.